नाम है जतिन दास।
Padma Bhushan awardee, eminent artist, academician, author and art activist, New Delhi, India, Shri Jatin Das. Interact with Professor Dr. Pradosh Mishra, eminent artist, Mr. Pradosh Swain, Professor Dr. Ranjan Malik, and founder of 5-Minute Arts, eminent artist Mr. Janardan Piramguru on the 8th of August 21.
Namaskar. Good evening. On behalf of 5 Minute Art, I invite all the viewers and especially our guest today evening, Jatin Dasji. So we are in fact blessed to have Jatin Dasji with us to have a 5-point discussion as a matter of experiment that we are going ahead with. So, before I formally welcome you, sir, just to give a background of what 5 Minute Art is, it's about, making new opportunities, creating new opportunities for the artists, for the art lovers and the students, in the time of pandemic, to create an avenue for them to explore their inner ability, their creativity, and put it before the audience. And, for that matter, I mean, they are doing a lot of initiatives. So, kudos to them. And this is one such experiment which has started with a Panch Baatein, discussion over 5 points. So, it's not like a question-answer session. And we are indeed grateful to Jatin Dasji for agreeing to be our guest today evening. And it is for us, people like us, in fact, blessed to have him with us and listen to him, because as we grew up from the state of Orissa, we have had opportunities in the past to listen to him, to understand his journey and his achievements and his progress as an artist. So, a very extremely highly respected artist. And he prefers not to be introduced in formal ways, as he always says, that, artist is always known by his works, not by the words that the host introduces him with. And with these words, and only, a couple of things that I'll be putting up before my audience, is that he is a meticulous observer. An observer to the to a level of nano observation standard. So that's how he observes the nature, that's how he observes the society, that's how he observes his subject. And the only result or manifestation that we find is his art. So this is one part of the introduction. The other part is that he is highly experienced, traveled, and have interacted with number of kinds of people in the world that has brought him to this space with that gamut of experience that he carries with himself. So I'm not going to talk about how many awards he has won, how many exhibitions he has held, how much paintings he has sold or he has been known for, but I am more keen to understand how these, 5 things we have thought to discuss with him is going to lead our imagination today. So with these small words, I welcome you, Jatin sir, to be with us. And it's, it's a blessing indeed to be with you and share space and, have a discussion like this. So indeed, it's a pleasure. So sir, and I'm not beginning with the question. The questions will come as, we have already decided, we are 4 members and we are trying to put up some, want to know something from you over 5 points. And I am also aware that we have got a very limited time within that we need to operate. And having said that, what are we actually looking forward to is, how your journey has been. Much of us have understood that because you have had you belong to Orissa, then you went to JJ School of Art, which was one of the air schools at that time when you were studying, and then your journey was really magnificent, and it moved from a small place to a global space. So with this, I think I will request Dr. Ranjan Malik to come up with his question first, and we'd like to request Jatin sir to kindly respond to his question.
Good evening to all. Jai Jagannath. This is not my questions. According to the format of Panche Baate is concerned, I will request to know from the Jatin sir, you have worked from the murals to canvas, painting to print, print to ceramics and sculpture also. Which medium you enjoy a lot and why, sir? Jatin sir.
Now it's clear. Okay. Yeah, Ranjan ki jo, whatever Ranjan said, before that I want to say that kya panche baate. That was very intriguing for me. That why five, why not four, why not six? So what I'm saying is panche baate, like a panchabhoot, five elements, five fingers. There are in our country, in many aspects of life, there are odd numbers. 3, 5, 7, 9. During the lockdown, I was sketching the plants and flowers in Asiad village where I live in Delhi. I found 99% of the flowers have 5 petals. And I was very intrigued. You can hear me? What I'm saying? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Please respond. I don't know whether you can hear me. Okay. So, before I start talking about paintings or drawings or graphics or anything, let me also say that all of us are born with some talent, God-gifted talent in our DNA. Somebody is good in mathematics, somebody good in music, somebody good in painting, etc. The basic elements of creativity. Every human being is creative. But when we talk of art, we do not pursue our talent. In our family, everybody push their children to go and do commerce or IT or go for IAS or engineering. We do not find out what is the talent of the child. What is he born with? Like, I'm very interested in music, but I can't sing for nuts. I don't have that talent. From my childhood, I was sketching and drawing. I was working in the garden in my hometown, you know? So, if you have a right environment, if your family gives you impetus, if your family encourages you to pursue what you are talented in, then it flourishes. Thereafter, it is riyaz. Thereafter, it is your practice. This is one thing. The other is, I'll be 80 end of this year in December. Aap sun sakte hain? Hello? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, okay.
As everybody can hear me? Okay. I went from Mayurbhanj. Mayurbhanj is an old princely state in the northern part of Orissa. And Baripada, the town, was very enriched with dance, music, painting, sculpture. People were good in sports. They are doing theater, etc., etc. There was Pramod Mahapatra, who went to Shantiniketan to study art. In summer, I used to go to him on summer days, midday, to learn watercolor from him. He's no more. when you continue and pursue your talent, when you continue and pursue and practice your God-gifted talent, then it is your riyaz and practice which takes you forward. The idea is, I never thought to be wanting to be rich or famous ever in my life. I only wanted to do my work better than before, better than before. I never compared myself with any other artist in my town or in the country or anywhere. I went at the age of 17 from Moyurbhanj to Sir JJ School of Art in Bombay. And it was a very interesting journey because I wanted to study art, but my parents and my elder brothers suggested there is no future in art. So they told me to do inter-science to go for medicine. So I did biology inter-science. While I was doing it, there was an inter-college youth festival in Cuttack, and I stood first in painting. Then I got excited. Then in 1956, there was an inter-university youth festival in Delhi, which I attended on behalf of my college and the university. So I stood first in that. When I returned, a friend of mine said, there is an art college called Sir JJ School of Art in Bombay. Why don't you apply? I applied. I couldn't get any reply from them. Then I had gone to Bhubaneswar. The then Bhubaneswar new capital was being built, and Julius Vaz, the great architect from Gregson Butler King in Bombay, who saw my sketches and wrote a letter to Professor Dilima in College of Architecture in JJ to give me admission. So when I went in the train, my father gave me 500 rupees and I went alone for the first time in the train to Bombay. And somebody was sitting next to me and he said he lives next door to JJ School of Art. And he said, come and stay with me. People were very gentle in those days. He took my clothes and my bags and beddings and I went straight here to JJ. Then the dean of the Faculty of Fine Arts said, it is already, the classes have already started. So I got admission in architecture. So after a few months, when I went to Professor Gondalekar, he then dean, so he said, okay, I'll give you admission interim. Then then I worked hard day and night. I used to do 300 sketches a day to study. So I got enthused. And I didn't look back then, or if it's only recently I'm looking back introspectively. Is it better? Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Keep connected so that we know that you can hear. So
yes,
I continued the first year. Second year, I got a freeship and scholarship because I did better. And then somebody in Revenchar College, friends of mine who were teaching English literature, and introduced me to somebody called Biju Patnaik. And why don't you hold an exhibition of your work in 1962 in Cuttack? So I had a show. Biju Patnaik was very happy. He bought a painting of mine. And I got 100 rupees Kalinga Foundation scholarship. So I had the free ship and 100 rupees Kalinga Foundation scholarship. Then I did not take a penny from home. From those days till now, I'm 80 years old. I have not taken money from home, not borrowed, not taken any loan, not sold any property to look after myself. And you'll be surprised to know that I do not even have a house of my own in Delhi. I live in an eminent artist quota allotment from the government of India. And my contemporaries have 8 houses, one in Bangalore, Bombay, Calcutta, Delhi, Ahmedabad, everywhere. So, just to tell you, I have never taken painting as a trading, painting as a business, painting as a profession. You know, the word profession has innumerable meanings. Painting is my life. Drawing and painting and working in visual material is my life. And I personally believe one life is not enough to become an artist. You need 2-3 lives to become an artist. Okay. Now, let me tell you, when I meet a young artist, I say, what do you do? And they say, I'm an artist, they say. And in my 40s, 50s and 60s, when I wrote in my brochure, my exhibition catalog, I wrote, I'm a painter, I want to become an artist. I'm a painter, I want to become an artist. Okay. Having said that, where I'm sitting here is a rented studio. 40 years younger than me, there are a lot of young artists who do very well. They're commercially viable. They're in the art market. I'm not in the art market at all. Not at all. Whether I've got a Padma Bhushan and I've got 4 or 5 doctorate, I'm a professor emeritus, I've 100 one-man show, these are all nonsense of no consequence. I don't have a house of my own. I have rented studio and I pay heavy rent. Whatever the money I earn, it gets spent in this. Then, another stupidity that I have, that I indulged in collecting handicraft, handloom, basketry, Costa Pitora Basan, and terracotta, and bronzes, and from not only from India and Orissa, but from China, Japan, Egypt, Africa, from many parts of the world. All sir, this sir, we'll be, related to the
genius. I'll just intervene, sir. We'll be coming to that also. In our first baatein, we'll be coming into that. So, you know, the best thing is that, you know, in our journey, one thing that you explained and which was really very inspiring, that you don't have a house. But I'll tell you one thing, you have a very energetic studio and that gives you life and you breathe with that.
Yes.
That is more important than having 5 houses and, you know, properties all over the world.
Studio. It's a rented studio.
The studio is rented. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So, I think we can go back to Professor Ranjan's, point that he raised.
Sure.
And try to understand, you know, how did you actually work when you started working on Mohenjo-daro to Mahatma Gandhi? What kind of inspiration? Yeah. So, what kind of an inspiration that you gathered? Because you were working on a cultural subject. For a political space. So having, you know, parallel between both, how did you actually engage with that subject?
Let me brief you that in my life, I have never approached anybody to give me work. Number one. Number two, I got a letter from the Parliament Secretariat for a mural. And some people were talking, I might be connected to BJP because in those days Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the Prime Minister. Or somebody. I'm not connected to any political party. I have no political lineage, etc. So I got a letter from Parliament that I wrote them back. I said, I can do the mural with less money, but I do not want any interference. What will be the subject? Mohenjo-daro Mahatma Gandhi was my subject I given. But they said 5,000 years of India. Then I said, I need a historian who should brief me for 6 months about India of 5,000 years. So they agreed. So I said, I need a 100-foot studio to paint there. They agreed. I said, Winsor Newton color from England. They agreed. They gave me a telephone. They gave me lunch. They gave me a car. But the money was very little. But so, what I'm saying is, I compromise with money, but I never compromise with my work.
Right.
When I was doing the mural, a lot of people said, they were passing by, they said, why don't you do something after Gandhi? I said, from Mohenjo-daro to Gandhi, I don't see anything beyond that, beyond Gandhi. So, I digested 5,000 years of India. Then I referred to hundreds of books. That I did hundreds of sketches and a cartoon. The word cartoon means a key sketch for a mural to the same size. That's a word called cartoon. So I did the mural is 7 feet by 68 feet. It was done for 2.5 years. It was inaugurated by the then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee in 2001. While I was doing the mural, there was a super cyclone in Odisha in 1999. And I was the president of Odisha Forum in Delhi. So, I'm a Boy Scout. So, I said, we'll go and work in a distracted village. So, I told the Parliament Secretariat, at this time, I can't do the mural. I'm working in a village in Odisha. And they agreed. They didn't know what to say, but they agreed. So, I went and worked in a village for a year and a half. And many people helped me. Doctors and their doctors and medicine, there's that. Many things I did. We'll talk about that separately. And right. But nobody came to help. Only Ganesh Mishra from Bangalore came to help. Anyway, there are many details about that. So I'm an indulgent person. Main kuch bhi karta ho na, usme ghus jata ho. Anything I do, I put my heart and soul to it. So I did that right. mural and that, and it was inaugurated. I've done some mural at the International Airport in Bangalore. I've done some mural in the Science Academy here. I did a big mural at the Chelsea Arts Club. That is a very honorable right. thing. In London, I'm a member. They had an exhibition, and very rarely they ask an artist to do a mural on 20 yeah. feet by 100 feet front wall. So I did that.
Yeah, I'll just keep informed my audience here that please go to jatindas.com website and look for the details of what he is saying, and you get all the details very clearly displayed in that website. So please visit, and you can also have find the biodata and also the work that he has done over a period of about 50 years. So that actually adds a lot to the to his information that you have. So with this, I think I'll go to Pradosh Shrine. Sorry.
Namaskar, Dada.
Yes.
Dada, this is not my question. This is a curiosity to me. That your work is so powerful that we can easily identify in the crowd, in your crowd. So I am talking about the stylization of work. Artist ka stylization ka bare mein puch raha hun. Stylization is a most important part in our journey. So I am just asking.
That's a very interesting.
Dada, that's why I am asking that. How you start, Dada? Because work I had seen your work was so powerful and realistic also and colorful also. How gradually you change and what was the thing behind particularly the stylization of your work, Dada? I'm asking you about that.
Okay, let me pick up. I'm very tempted to talk about this. I will answer your point. Number one, I have been also a teacher. I've also been a professor of art. And I tell my students, lot of teachers tell them to refer to some other artist's books. I say, look at everything, don't refer to anybody. Number one. Number two, lot of teachers tell their students to develop your style. It's a very wrong thing for a teacher to say. A style is born on its own. Style is mannerism. Quite often people refer to a style as mannerism. हुसैन का पेंटिंग देख के एक जैसा लगता है इट्स मैनरिज्म इज नॉट स्टाइल इज नॉट नोन टू एन आर्टिस्ट स्टाइल इज अननोन टू एन आर्टिस्ट ए सिंगर कुमार गंधर और भीमसेन जोशी वन द सिंग देयर वोकल कॉर्ड इज देयर ओन दैट इज देयर इनहेरेंट क्वालिटी Any sensitive artist in any field, dance, music, painting, poetry, anything, he doesn't look at his style. Let me tell you something else. When I paint and draw, I don't look at my work at all. I always paint and turn the painting back to the wall. You get my point? I don't refer to my work at all. And when I draw, when I have a blank sheet of paper, when I paint on a canvas, a blank canvas, I feel as if I've never painted, drawn before. So for me, it's a contemplation and a dedication and a total involvement which I can't explain to others.
that gradually,
I don't think about it. Yeah.
It comes gradually, that what we are seeing today. This.
Yeah. Can't hear you. Can't hear you. Can't hear you.
Yes, brothers, go ahead.
Everybody is developing their style. कपड़ा कैसे पहनते हैं, कैसे ये करते हैं, these are superficial things. Style, you know, these are expressions which come from the West. You know, quite often style is mistaken as mannerism. You know what I mean? Kumar Gandharv, when he sings a particular raga, every time his raga is different. You know what I mean? So, how do I explain?
I'll tell you one thing. I think I can, add a little to what you said, in fact. When I was, before we come into this electronic platform, I was looking at your website, and what I found to my, interest is that your forms, they're so apparent. They look all equal in your drawing, in your contest, in your painting, and as well as your sculptures. You know, the sculptures that you have created, they also carry the same nuances, the same force, the kind of same, they just become three-dimensional. So, when one looks at those words, they're so together. They're not different in mediums. So that is where I think the mannerism is over, and that is the language that you speak. I think I agree to that.
May I say that I don't have narrative paintings. I can't explain my painting. Only thing to say, my paintings are not narrative. They're not telling a story. Normally, my paintings are single figure or two figures. And I don't know why.
Yeah.
You get my point? when I work, the work demands from me. I also write poetry. And when I share these thoughts with my counterparts, my contemporaries anywhere in the world, they speak the same language. You write a first line of the poem, that first line guides you to the rest of the poem. You draw a first line on a paper, that line guides you what to do. So there is a atmiyata. There is a relationship between your work and you. Sometimes your work guides you, sometimes you guide the work.
Yes, sir. Art is your journey,
this game goes on, this leela. You know what I mean? But I'm still a child. Still learning.
Thank you, Deva.
Yeah. Sir, exactly. Sir, I'll just take you back to, through my memory lane. When you came to Banaras, and we have met a couple of times in Banaras, and every time you are actually surrounded by students, you are so powerful that you just carry them in a stride and tell them, do you have a sketch book and do you have a pencil? If you don't have, then what kind of a student you are? So you have been so pedagogic in your approach. If you are an artist, or if you are practicing art, even if you are not an artist, if you are just practicing art, then you must carry your tools every time so that the tool can be used at any moment of your a movement. And then I have found for myself what kind of a curiosity that arises in these students' mind, and they just get down and start working along with you. And I still remember when you were working with the students in a palatial building in Banaras, how interestingly all those 4 days you could manage to bring in people and do sketches all the day. So can you just elaborate?
Let me interrupt and tell you something very interesting about that time. When I came to Banaras, all these young people were taking photographs. Click, 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 click. They were taking photographs. So I said, you're taking photographs. When I was your age, I used to sketch. Why didn't you? So after lunch, Banaras, the young people were so lovely, unlike Bombay and Delhi. After lunch, they all came back with sketchbook, no camera. And not only they started sketching those 4 days, even during the music concert by the Ganges, they were sketching at 2 a.m. And I was very happy. So wherever I go, often I decide that I will not go again. Okay. But sometimes when something like this happens, that I feel satisfied that ek to drop kahi to dala, you know, that drop in the ocean, that kids are enthused, you know, to carry on sketching. Because riyaz is very important. As a teacher, I know you cannot make anybody an artist. Only our job to give them a foundation, to trigger them, unko khujli karne ka thoda. Khujli karke, hard work, riyaz, practice, and practice from nature, not from other artists' work at all, which is wrong, which is a wrong method of teaching. The kind of form, tone, color, shape, light that there is in nature, aadmi pagal ho jayega. Aap ekin karo, believe me, even now when I see a flower, white flower with purple inside, and inside there is yellow. Wo to aadmi pagal ho jayega na, kaisa kiya? And it's not merging with each other at all. How does the nature does it? You know, so I draw leaves and flowers and I take the energy from that. So when I do human beings, I never refer to my earlier work. I don't refer to any artist, but I digest the sculptures, the miniatures and nature. I am rooted to my country. Not that I'm not exposed to the rest of the world. I've visited many countries, I've visited many museums, I know many artists. And I use a different expression. I steal the energy of others. Main dusre ka energy ko chori karta hu. I steal the energy of others, but I don't copy them. I don't, unka energy teach leta hu. So you see, when I was in art school in JJ, my only sister was in Shantiniketan doing her master's in literature. So every summer vacation I spent in Shantiniketan. Kinkarda was very fond of me. I did a portrait of Kinkarda in 1961, which he has signed. And Sarvari Rai Chaudhary and these people.
Yeah.
What a lovely time. And when Kinkarda used to do the sculpture in cement, I was standing next to him and the whole of Shantiniketan was sleeping in summer during the day. And used to sing and do the sculpture. So, what happens is you have to have role model. I had a Professor Palsikar in JJ School of Art.
Yes.
I had Kinkarda. I have the Mahabalipuram. I have Khajuraho Konark. The Jain sculptures, the miniatures, the Kerala murals, the Ajanta Ellora. Suniye. I went as a student to about 4 or 5 years ago. I was invited to Maharashtra to an art school, I forget, Aurangabad. On the way back, I went to Ellora. After 60 years, I went to Ellora. Main toh pagal ho gaya. Prithivi mein, nobody Michelangelo tuchha hai uske saamne. The kind of elephant of 20 feet fighting with a lion. Monolithic rock. मैं तो अभी भी मेरा लोमांच हो रहा है. If artists have done that, मैं कुछ नहीं हूँ. मैंने कुछ नहीं किया. आप समझे? मुझे तो जब एलोरा के बारे में सोचता हूँ, दुनिया का सब भूल जाए. हैं? कभी स्कल्पचर देखिए कोणार्क में कि खजुराहो में कोई a female figure turning and half smiling. साला nobody has done. You see, this country and the Eastern world, which is between East to Japan and China and the entire, or the ancient world of Africa, Egypt, Persia, in me sattva hai. In the ancient culture, there is sattva. That, kya kahun? Suniye, in America, they say, how you win is important. No, the process is not important. In India, to Japan, they say, the process is important. Process. The final right. Product is not important.
Right.
अब समझ रहे हैं ना? तो कर्मण ने बाध्य कार्यस्तु फलेषु कदाचित. So if एक राजकुमार जब जाते थे पहले गुरुकुल में, they used to be like everybody else. तो राजकुमार says, I want to sing. So guru said, okay, you want to sing, then you start learning painting. He goes to the painting teacher. Painting there, you want to paint. Go and learn sculpture, etc., etc., etc. Learn rhythm. उसको इवेंचुअली राजकुमार को कपड़ा धोने, गाय को संभालने, पौधा को संभालने भेज दिया नेचर में, टू नेचर. इन द नेचर ही लिसन टू द कलकल ऑफ द रिवर, टू द ब्रीज, हवा का, और कपड़ा धोने का, बर्तन धोने का, गाय को पालने का. एंड देन द गुरु वन डे कम्स इन विंटर कि चलो अभी ठंडी में नदी में नहा के. Now you do sa. Because he spent 2 years in the nature, he had imbibed natural elements. Aap samjhe?
Right.
So, to be an, in a country, ab dekho na, those who do sculptures, in the traditional sculptures, or do patachitra, they sit down and work, they don't show off. In my JD Center of Art, in 2004, I had a sculptor's camp and a potter's camp. And there were traditional sculptors and contemporary sculptors. Jo contemporary sculptors the, unko grinder chahiye, ye chahiye, wo chahiye. Aur jo traditional sculptors the, ek patla cheni aur ek mota cheni aur ek hathodi, bas. Ab samajh rahe? Hamara contemporary artist ka bahut nakhra hai. And we learned this nakhra from the Western world. Western world में कुछ नहीं है, nothing, rubbish. You see, let me go back to another word called museum. You know what's a museum in Hindi? Sangrahalay, which is a storehouse. Or Bengal में बोलते हैं जादूघर. समझ रहे? So we need art center, not a museum. Museums are there where they have no art in day to day life, in the tradition. You know, हमारे देश में रास्ता तो आर्ट है. गुजरात में, राजस्थान में, तमिलनाडु में, केरला में, असम में, उड़ीसा में, कहीं भी आप जाएंगे, इट्स आर्ट एवरीवेयर, यू नो. सो वन इज नेचर एंड द अदर इज द थाउजेंड ऑफ इयर्स ऑफ ट्रेडिशन वी हैव टू इनवाइट, यू नो. सो आई फाइंड लॉट ऑफ आवर कंटेम्पररी आर्टिस्ट इन आवर कंट्री टूडे एंगेजिंग यंग ट्रेडिशनल artists to do their drawing, do their painting. बहुत सारे आपको मालूम होगा मेरे पेंटिंग में कोई हाथ नहीं लगाता. मेरे पेंटिंग में other than helping stretching canvas or priming the canvas or cleaning the brush, I don't have my assistant or my art assistant or my pupil touch my painting. I'm sorry to say,
lot
of young artists today, है ना,
आपका फोर्सफुल स्ट्रोक को हम टच नहीं कर पाएंगे दादा, कोई टच नहीं कर पाएगा दादा.
नहीं तो ये एक बात यहाँ से जो उभर के आती है, बिकॉज दिस एक्चुअली टेम्प्ट्स मी एंड वी हैव वेरी स्मॉल यू नो एंड वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टॉक टू यू दैट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू हैव योर रिस्पॉन्स ऑन दिस. That suppose you know, because your training is so deep rooted and you have you know that entire training process is so meaningful that you know it actually nurtures your mind from within, and that is the emphasis. But nowadays, yes, with these mediatic interventions, with this kind of a lot of mediums coming in like video performance, you know, a lot of other mediums which are pulling. Where actually do you think, actually are we breaking away from, you know, that particular process of understanding art, or is it actually taking us to a new realm? You know, how do you respond to that?
Right. Very good point. Our society, the world has changed. An American artist does a 20 feet canvas with only red. And he says if the color falls apart, it's the job of the conservationist. साला को थप्पड़ लगाना चाहिए. The point is, we were taught how to prime a canvas, how to stretch a canvas. You don't prime once, you prime 5 times. Patla coating, it has to dry. Priming is not done in monsoon, priming is done in winter when the air will be dry. Okay, number one. A lot of people don't know how to stretch a canvas. Okay. Having primed properly, etc. मैं एक बात कहूंगा. आई हैव अ यंग आर्ट असिस्टेंट कॉल्ड अलाप शाह, लवली बॉय, who comes to me for last 12 years from Baroda. He did his bachelor's and master's. I was invited by Koirala Foundation to Nepal. And we went to see, wherever I go and look at traditional art. And I visit contemporary artists also, but I look at it. We went to a Tanka painter. You know what he said to Alap? He said, Alap bhai, to be an artist, bahut kasht ka kaam hai, number one. And he stretched a kapda and he was grinding a stone on the kapda for 10 days. Then priming and grinding for another 10 days. He did a tanka for 1 year. Ab samajh rahe hain? So, Sunar, I respect a goldsmith, I respect a blacksmith, I respect a gardener, I respect a cook, I respect a classical. Mujhe na role model kahin hai, mujhe mera role model kaun hai malum hai? Bhimsen Joshi. Mera role model hai Kalidas. Mera role model hai Mahabalipuram. Aap samajh rahe? Mera role model hai jo ikat ka saadi bunta hai Sambalpur mein. वो मेरा रोल है. आपको मालूम है 12 साल का लड़का है, ही टाइज द थ्रेड एंड देन ओपन्स इट अप देन वीव्स इट. मेरे तो मैं पागल हो जाऊंगा, मुझे रात को नींद नहीं आता है. और हाउ कम यू नो ऑल दीज ब्लडी वीडियो थिंग एंड इंस्टॉलेशन एंड ऑल दैट इज इन. हमारा जब फल बिकता है, वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट्स दे इंस्टॉल, दैट्स अ इंस्टॉलेशन, एम आई राइट? व्हेन यू मिठाई बेचते इंस्टॉलेशन है, जब कपड़ा बेचते इंस्टॉलेशन है. ये नथिंग रो, देयर आर मेनी ब्यूटीफुल थिंग्स आल्सो कम इन मॉडर्निटी है. जैसे कि अपना अनीश कपूर ने कोई बड़ा बैलून बना दिया साला 500 फीट का. आई सॉ अनीश कपूर फर्स्ट एग्जीबिशन स्टूडेंट का लंदन में. वो पाउडर का रंग का जो होता है ना होली के लिए, रेड ब्लू येलो तसला में रंग है, आई सॉ दैट ही हैड इट देयर. And he had it in many exhibitions thereafter. Many. And in Royal Academy, he had an exhibition where tons of wax, a machine jaake kutta tha, bas. Kya batao? Suno. The baat ye hai, if you buy cooked food and then put it into, kya bolte hai, microwave, it's not the same as growing vegetable, then cutting the vegetable, then cooking a dish, then eating it. You get my point? So if you prime your canvas, do you know when you go to buy paper in a store, I don't let them touch my paper. I pull it out myself. 90% of the shops and young artists who draw, paint, etc., I seen them, I observe it in an art material shop, they pull it like some kachara. When I pull a sheet of paper, for me it's gone. You know, it's a space to deal with. On that, I'm going to draw. I don't like a little crease on my paper. I'm very fussy. I'm very particular about my material. So, I was talking about painting. We were taught in JJ, if I'm going to put vermilion on the canvas, I have to put a particular kind of green. I have to put a particular kind of burnt umber. Then I put red. When you do you know when they put gilding, gold lagate hain jab, gold ke piche red hota hai, brown hota hai. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? But those blacksmith, those who do carving, those who do other things in the craft, they follow a systematic method. Do you know when they make a chola bronze, they put milk on the top of it, and the milk flows down to the toe, that means the balance is proper. आप समझ रहे? In our country, in all the ancient countries, the approach to art and life is very simple, very innocent, very pure, and not complicated.
Sir, we'll come to the last one. It's a wonderful conversation, but we have got a time limit. The last question, I think we have Guru to, he was saying to take something from you. So please, Guru, go ahead and ask the question.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. Actually, my question is, you have conceptualized a Pankha Museum in JD Center, Bhubaneswar, Odisha. What inspired you?
That's wrong. No, hello. I'm doing an art center in Bhubaneswar, which will have more than 26 galleries. It will be the only place in the country for folk, tribal, classical and contemporary art. There'll be a gallery for architecture, gallery for photography, gallery for bronze, gallery for miniature, toys, etc. But I have a Pankha collection. Another stupidity and indulgence that I have, 46 years ago, I started, somebody gifted me a fan, an antique fan. I said, I will make a collection of Pankha. Bas man mein aa gaya. To pagalpan se main ghus gaya isme. So, today I have the largest Pankha collection in the world. 8,500 Pankha. There are four documentaries I have made, about 10. Then there's a Pankha book in the offing. Pankha poems which has come. Sahitya Academy in Delhi doing a book. And I am begging the government to do a National Pankha Museum. If they do it, I will donate my Pankha collection to the thing. So let my friends and artists plead to the government. If they do it, it's a rare, a dying craft. And it has been shown in Kennedy Center in America, been shown in Pankha Museum in London, in Zurich in Rydberg Museum, Kuala Lumpur Philippine National Museum, and Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts in Delhi Craft Museum, etc., etc. It's all over. This is in store. And my children are saying, please round up your project. Your 80 sala kabhi chala jaoga. One day I'll pass out. And many of these things will be, you know, I have nobody to help me. It'll be too much of a load on my children. You know what I mean? I have three children and they'll be loaded with instead of doing that thing.
So, sir, this idea of JD Art Center, which has come up very nicely with Bibi Joshi's design, JD Center for Art. So that's a wonderful design of Bibi Joshi. How do you plan that center, in fact? Actually, that's what, because you are already organizing lecture programs, you have got a huge collection of art materials. So, how you are planning that?
My younger son, Siddhartha, is looking after, he's from NID, National Institute of Design. He's a museum designer. He's now looking after, but last 24 years, it started in 1997. Since then, yes. I've sent two of my cars there. I've been paying salary, etc., from my painting money. And I don't sell much at all. I'm not in the art market. The other day, somebody came to my studio. He said, you are not in the art market, but I see your studio full of many kinds of work. You know? Anyway, so I spend money for that. And I will beg all the artists to come forward, donate a work. I have no hidden agenda. I'm not secret agenda. Only thing is, if I did it in Delhi, I would get a lot of help. But I'm doing it in Bhubaneswar in Odisha because our state, and also away from metro, it should be done there. One block is ready. It will, by God willing, it will open by winter this year. Interior is being done. Okay. It has been locked down because of the lockdown. So it's going on. But I want artists to join hands. Main aapko khatam karne ke pehle ek cheez bolna chahta hu. 50 saal pehle, Kishan Khanna and Ram Kumar were having an exhibition in Bombay, separately. Somebody came to buy a painting of Kishan Khanna. You know what Kishan Khanna said? Go and buy a Ram Kumar first, then I will sell you my painting. They had a camaraderie. We don't have a camaraderie between artists. I go to every exhibition to see everybody's work. Everybody talks ill about other artists. मैं तो बोल रहा हूँ ना, आर्टिस्ट होने के लिए तीन जन्म चाहिए, है ना?
बिल्कुल.
एक जन्म में आर्टिस्ट नहीं बन सकता.
Exactly.
You know, let me tell you, if we don't sketch and draw and riyaz, next time when you're going to draw your finger, काम नहीं करेगा, you know?
Yeah.
So, fortunately, I knew Ravi Shankar, I knew Vilayat Khan, I knew Kumar Gandhav. I did a portrait sketch of Gulam Ali Khan in 1960, which he signed. I've got a 400-page portrait book done, but it's not sold because I don't know how to sell it. controlled answer.
Right.
Yeah. So I indulge in doing things. I want all my artist friends who are listening, let them dedicate their life to their work and forget about everything right. else. Yeah. Then only they will enjoy. If they do it, they will enjoy the work. Raku neend nahi aana chahiye.
But you know, one thing that I always appreciate that even after having traveled the entire world and having worked for, you know, working for so long time, you have chosen Bhubaneswar to have your art place, you know, this Jetty Center for the Arts, because that is so important to think about the vernacular, because now everything is getting so centralized and it needs very badly to decentralize and go back to our roots. And if everybody is not contributing to that, then perhaps we are not going to sustain the kind of you know, art that we are practicing now. And it will not also encourage the people back our homes, because you know it is a kind of motivation. So when you are doing that, you are also motivating the young artists of that space, and they are getting energized by looking at the works and your motivation and your enthusiasm at this age and your inspiration. Yeah. So they are looking forward to that. And I think everybody must come together and, you know, join their hands to rescue, I mean, that's if it is the right word, the Pankha collection, because that is one of the historic collection in India at least, because this is not a craft, this is an art which has been practiced by our rural folk and has been very nicely documented. Yes, so it is actually very well documented and very rare forms you can find in that collection. So personally, I have seen that. So I am very enthused and I am inspired by that. So I think what we can do in a manner of camaraderie, like you requested, that we can get together and write to Government of Orissa to put everything together. And if they are extending, I came to know that they are having an annex and everything. So why not divert some fund and make a gallery for this and collect them for the posterity? I think this will give a lot of idea to our future artists.
Last 50 or 40 years, I've been writing to Orissa government and Lalit Kala Academy, hold an exhibition of all the Oriya artists who are dead, Oriya artists who are older, Oriya artists who are young, hold an exhibition, have a gallery, do a book. In, you know, Kerala, look at Kerala, what they're doing. Look at Gujarat. Look at Gujarat. In last 70, 80 years, they've done a fantastic. Do you know every Gujarati buys a Gujarati artist's work? Bhupen Khakkar ka sabka, Jyoti Bhatt ka sab Gujarat mein kharikte hai. Do you know in India, now in Orissa, other than Biju Patnaik, nobody has a sketch of mine in Orissa. Bhai, kya baat kar rahe? Not a, the famous writers and poets do not have a drawing of any young artist of Orissa. So that's why hundreds of artists of Orissa are in Calcutta, Bombay, Delhi, full of Korean artists. We have look at those three young artists in Kerala, what they are doing, you know.
Yeah.
Look at Bihar. Bihar has done a fantastic one, the best museum in Asia.
Yeah.
Eh? Done by Maki, the Japanese architect. And I have met the architect. And the museum is a proper museum. National Gallery of Modern Art in Delhi, Jaipur House, was a Jaipur Raja ka ghar tha. It's not a museum. Are you getting what I'm saying? So it is a museum. Do you know Jay? The Bihar Museum has bought my painting. Bihar Museum.
Yes, I've seen that.
Bihar Museum.
I've seen that.
You have a retro show of mine. Orissa mein kisi ke paas mera drawing nahi hai. Acha, mujhe bhul jaiye. Lekin hazaro jo young artist hai, unka to drawing kharido bhai Orissa mein. Hai, bichare hai. Pathetic.
Bihar is doing that.
Who's going to give me the brushes? He's got a brush collection. Parik Rai. And he's going to give me the brushes for the JDC. I'm going to have a brush gallery. I'm going to have a gallery for brushes only. I also have a few hundred brushes. You know, so some dilna chahiye. Ye art to kya hai? Ye Bhagwan ki kripa se hota hai. Aur kasht karke. You know, you have to work hard and by God's blessing.
Right.
Without that, and as I said, one life is not enough. And either socializing, networking करने से कुछ नहीं होगा. You will become rich, you will build a house. और उसके बाद क्या?
Right.
You'll buy a car. So then,
sir, we are almost at the fag end of our time. We are almost at the fag end of our time. So, so on behalf of 5 Minute Park, I extend my hearty, gratitude and thank you so much. And जैसे आपने कहा कि one life is not enough for an artist. One 5 baatein is not enough to understand Jatin bhai. So it will take again, at least a number of times to come back and listen to you. You have been really fascinating and very inspiring. And the many times I listen to you, that many times I get so inspired by your ideas. The way you try to inculcate your ideas in the children, in the school children, in the college students, and the way you inspire them to come back to arts and to themselves. More than getting away from it, because there is no practice of skating nowadays. It has reduced a lot. So with your inspiration, people are coming back to those practices, and they are getting motivated by you. Even at this age, if you can motivate the young people.
Sorry. Before we finish, just one word. There is a school in Delhi called Sardar Patel Vidyalaya. It's one of the best school in the country, yes. Where my daughter and elder son has studied. My youngest son is studying there. They have no art teacher. There's a Oriya young fellow who's gone on a contract to chart there. Can you imagine? Can you imagine a school doesn't have an art teacher? 90% yeah. of the schools have no painting on the walls. So kya baat kar rahe
hai? But recently, as per the new policy, Dada, but new education policy with the art is more like the science and other subject. So now the government is bound to appointment the art teacher like the science and mathematics. So it is a good thing. Nowadays from 2021 onwards, new education policy is made, they have to bound to appointment the art and craft teachers. So it's a good thing.
Yeah.
They have no option to ignore this art subject.
No, but this was decided. This was decided even 100 years ago. Art is an integral part of life, of education. If you take a child and the art teacher, mathematics teacher, music teacher and botany teacher together in the garden, look at a branch of a tree, there's a rhythm, alternate or together. The leaves start from one place or alternatively, so the color, the form, the botanical thing, the rhythm in music, all this can be taught together. Our syllabus and approach is wrong. Ye din raat aap kyun kar rahe hain, gaana kyun ga rahe hain ghar pe, jaake padhai karo. The institution of home and school are destroyed in the society. One day, this is the last. One day some municipal people came and said, आप यहाँ क्या करते हैं? बोला मेरा पेंटिंग का स्टूडियो है. हाँ, फोटो स्टूडियो. फोटो स्टूडियो. They don't know painting studio. स्टूडियो तो होता है फोटो का. अब समझ रहे
हैं? हम लोग perhaps we have failed in educating our society.
No, it's an uphill task. We had everything in our life, in our country. We had everything. It's all destroyed. So we all have to join hands. Thank you very much. I'm sorry for speaking.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining and agreeing to join us and blessing us with your presence. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
sir.
All the best.
Thank you.